And the truth is, Jesus said that there would be false Christ. The truth is that there are false brothers. The truth is that there is only one true gospel. There is only one true Lord, one faith, one baptism. But there is also a false gospel. But the apostle Paul tells us clearly that if any man preach any other gospel to you, then that which you have received, let him be accursed. So you can receive a false gospel and no one's preaching it to be accursed. But we want to tell you today the true gospel. And the true gospel is we must be born again. We must be born again. And so it's loving to tell you the true gospel that can save your soul. It's unloving, it's not loving to share with you a gospel that tells you that you can still do things contrary and even contrary to how God wants you to live and still call yourself a Christian. What a Christian is someone who lives and acts like Jesus Christ.
Amen.
We are warned in Scripture. Jesus himself said, many will say unto me in that day, Lord, Lord, have we not prophesied in your name, and have we not cast out devils? But you will say to these people, depart from me, I never knew you. You that work iniquity. That means you who practice sin. That means you who practice sin will not inherit the kingdom of God. This is a mighty message that we share with you today. That you cannot be a Christian and practice sin. You're taking a step further. Many of us want to align with those who practice sin. We want to align with those who practice sin. My Bible tells us that to come out from among them and be ye therefore separate, saith the Lord.
And they're saying, you're not God.
Not the unclean thing, but I will receive you. So when you live and you dwell among and you fellowship with those who practice sin, you're in a place of life. Many of us are in bondage right now because we have either received this false gospel. We went to an altar and we prayed a prayer, but we have not been regenerated. And I was one who believed that. I said, yes, the people spoke, okay, well, now you're saved. But I had no change in my life. There was no power to stop sinning. There was no power in my life. So I went on nightclubs, adultery, and things that I'm too ashamed to mention to you today. But the Lord Jesus Christ set me free, hallelujah. We can set you free. But if one of the kingdom is up, after 10 years of ministry, taking the sins out of my life, that I have the true gospel, and that is repentance towards God. We need to change your mind. We need to turn from sin. We need to put your trust in Jesus. Turn from your sin and put your trust in Jesus. And that was missing. That's what was missing in my life. But I want to share with you today as a living testimony that you can be set free from sin. I was set free from the bondage of sin, and you can be set free as well. If any man practices sin, the sin of righteousness is not in him. You cannot practice sin and call yourself a Christian. Listen, in this church, and I'm not going to make, but in this church that I have become a false convert because of a gospel that was not true, that was not full, it was only a half gospel, it wasn't a true gospel that many of you are bound by today. In this place, I even went through the new members class. I even got baptized, and I was not saved. So there are many of you who probably, here is somebody here that likely went through the same thing. But just because you repeat a prayer, or because you get go through a new members class does not mean that you are saved. You are saved when you put your trust in Jesus, when you turn from your sins, and you receive His Holy Spirit that dwells inside you. He talks to you. He convicts you of sin, of righteousness. He lives and dwells in you. You can have that today. You can have the Holy Spirit dwelling inside you. But you must be willing to repent. You have to repent. You have to stop sinning. The Bible says that let everyone that nameth the name of Christ depart from iniquity. Are you ready to depart from iniquity, or do you want to hang on to your sin? You see, the problem is many people still want to hang on to their sin. They want to hang on to fornication. They want to hang on to adultery. They want to hang on to pornography. They want to hang on to masturbation. They want to hang on to homosexuality. They want to hang on to the lifestyle of committing lies and being angry at your brother without a cause. You want to hang on to that. But you can be free from that. What has it done for you? It even damages your health. It's even scientifically proven that when you live like that, it damages your health. Physically. But God came that you could have life and have it more abundantly. And this abundant life does not mean that you're going to be rich. But what it does mean is you're going to be rich in Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You're going to be rich in God. God, hallelujah. You're going to be rich in Jesus. Oh, praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
You're going to be rich in Jesus. And when you're rich in Jesus, Jesus provides everything that you need. Hallelujah. He provides what you really need, and that is a spiritual relationship with God. Look up in the sky. Look up who created this. God Almighty. You can have a relationship now with God Almighty if you repent and turn from your sins and put your trust in what Jesus Christ has done. And what He did was He shed His cross for the sins of mankind, that whosoever believeth will not perish, but have everlasting life. And that word believing is a trusting. And if you trust, you obey. You want to obey. So the problem is a false gospel that says you don't have to obey. You don't have to turn from sin. But you can put your trust in Jesus. If you're willing to turn from sin, He can set you free from your sins. And He came to set you free. Whosoever the Son sets free,
He
shall
free
be free indeed. He indeed me. That's the word, set you free. Amen.
Amen.
No one can save you. There's none other name given under heaven whereby men must be saved. You cannot be saved by Muhammad. You cannot be saved by Buddha. None of them can save you. Only Jesus can save you.
Amen.
Because Jesus is God. And He came down as God in the flesh, took on flesh.
Woo!
And He gave His life for you and shed His precious blood. How precious is that blood? The blood of Jesus that was shed for you. And when you reject Jesus, there is nothing else. That there's nothing left but a fearful look when you stand before God in judgment. It's appointed unto men once to die and after that the judgment. And we're telling you of a reality that you're not thinking about right now. There is a hell and there is eternal life with God. If you reject Jesus, if you die in your sins, you will go to hell. And that's what we don't want you to go there. And that's why we're here sharing this today. Listen, your eternal life is more important to us than the podcast. It's more important to us that you have life, have eternal life. And praise the Lord, Jesus is coming soon. And you don't know. None of us know tomorrow is not promised. Tomorrow is not promised. You're not going to be able to blame anyone. So the thing is also, as I talked about this false gospel, you're not going to be able to stand before God and say, oh, well, I heard this false gospel. No, you have a responsibility. And we're not here to tickle your ears. We're here to tell you the truth. So when you hear this truth, you're going to be accountable for it. You're going to be accountable to it today. Because many of you have heard the true gospel. You cannot practice sin and live a life as a Christian. You have to turn. You have to submit to God. He is God Almighty. He says the earth is His footstool. It says the nations are as a drop in his bucket. A nation as a drop in his bucket? That's a big God. That's the one and true God. Hallelujah. But you wanna let the God of this world blind you, which is Satan, the little God of this world, you wanna let him blind you and keep you blinded, keep you distracted with all of this, when there's something more serious at stake, which is your eternal life? This life is but a drop in a bucket. This life is so small, but eternal life, I mean, that's forever. Do you guys think of that? Does that even cross your mind, or do you think it's going to be some type of dirt nap? Let me tell you, when you die and wake up on the other side, there's going to be more real than you are standing here now today. And the reason why is because the next life is eternal. It's going to be more real there than here. So we're here to tell you about this real place that you're going to go to when you die. And it's either going to be eternity in heaven with God or eternity in hell. And there is weeping, gnashing of teeth, and where the word dieth not. And you may not even heard that in your church, but we're telling you today, come out from among them and be separate. If you listen, there's some godly men right here, and many of them will pray for you. They will minister to you so that you can be set free. If you have anything in bondage, if you're bondage to anything, if you're a slave to sin, you can be set free today. These men is going to pray for you, and you can get set free. You can get set free from demonic oppression. You can be set free from demonic possession. You can be set free. You can be delivered from that today. We say the sunset peace, that we peace in you. Hallelujah.